afternoon baseball now from the desert southwest and Chase Field here in downtown Phoenix. Zach Gallen gets the call to pitch here. So here is Raimel Tapia, lifetime in this matchup. He's a 333 hitter. That's a hit, the first of the new season. Hampson rounds third and is digging for the plate, and the runner will score from first. And happy birthday as they allow him to cross with the inside the park home run as he catches his breath to reflect on his goal. Up next, Dante Vaughn. First delivery to him. Oh, and a hearty cut there to begin the at-bat. It's nothing in one. LoCastro, a runner at first with one gun in the inning. Throw over to the bag, and he'll get back in safely. And another throw over, keeping particularly close tabs on him. Ready with the 0-1. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. And there are our umpires calling balls and strikes is Mr. Ed Drummond.
Yeah, Matty, hey, you know what, Dero? This Ed Drummond, he's a good umpire. Fair umpire, good ball and strike umpire, pretty much straight down the road.
That's all you look for, Dan. Just be consistent. I don't care if you're given 2 to 3 inches off the outside corner, but you can't do it on the inside corner. If you're going to stick to one thing and stay consistent with it, no player will have a gripe with you.
A swing and a miss for out number two, and a ball he had no chance of making contact with. Now one down with the bases empty, and now digging in will be Sam Hilliard. Swing and a little blooper to center. In comes the center fielder. He makes the running play. Two down. And that'll bring in Garrett Hampson. Lifetime against this particular arm. He's got 3 base hits in 19 tries. 7 strikeouts on the stat sheet as well. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So good work on a 1-2 count to get on base.
Hey, D-Roll, that's just...
Next up is Dante Vaughn. 0-for-1 here in the early going. And now the first pitch. And he goes with the pitch here and drives it the other way to deep right. Going back is the right fielder. A leap, but he can't bring it back into the park. It's a home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. First home run of the campaign for it. And the Diamondbacks forge ahead. It's now 3-2.
Facing an elite starter, you know lungs are going to be at a premium. I don't know if this shakes the starter's confidence, but you know what it does? It certainly boosts the confidence of the guys in your lineup.
Next, it'll be Casey Golden comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. 2-2. This is skied into the air to straightaway center. Vaughn will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. Now to the plate, Ramon Marquez threw a base on balls his first time up. 0-2 pitch. Swinging a little blooper to center, and that's going to fall for a base hit. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late. And now, Garrett Hampson, one in, one out, and one on here in the inning. Now here's a shot out to right center field. Marquez rounds the corner and is headed home. Safe at the plate as they extend their lead to 3.
we take a look here, it's just a good piece of hitting and good hustle, driving the second run of the inning home and putting himself 90 feet away with just one out.
Hit in the air out to center field. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third. And he will score on the sacrifice fly.
That was a good controlled swing out of him there.
Ready now for the Diamondbacks. Dante Vaughn comes in one for two with that home run he hit earlier.
Going back to that last AB, that was the express. That was an upper 90s fastball that he turned around. So I think with this guy, you might want to try to incorporate some more off-speed pitches.
No balls in one strike. The 0-1 pitch is swung out and missed for strike number two.
0-2.
Pitcher's got options here. He looked a little bit out front. Might be able to rush a fastball by him.
On a good changeup, a swing and a miss, and he's set down on strikes for the second. Now to the plate. Here is Herman Marquez. The 2-1 home.
Marquez.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Vaughn is there now, and he has it. Two gone. So next to bat will be Dante Vaughn, who went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
The 1-0 is swung on and missed, strike one.
One ball, one strike.
That swing had one purpose, and that was to put the ball over the wall. I guess he doesn't have much to lose with his team down this many at this point in the game.
Count is 1-2 now. Trying to strike him out for the third time. Now here's a comebacker back to the mound.
Beat it out.
And he'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning.
Your attention, please. Pinch hitting for the Rockies. Number two, Jonathan Gaza.
Hit in the air to center field. Vaughn under it, and he makes the catch for out number. William Ouellette is out from the bullpen now, as he'll get the call here on opening day. Bottom of the inning now, and digging in is the outfielder Dante Vaughn. He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
0-1.
And ooh, I'm not sure you can get fooled worse than that. It's 0-1.
Man, that pitch had the look of a fastball. Straight changeup, the bottom fell out of it.
And he pumps the fastball by him at 94. It's 0-2.
Looked like he was going to wait him out, see if he was going to come over the heart of the plate. Well, newsflash, he is, and this hitter is going to adjust his batting gloves, and he better be ready in the box.
Now a right-hander has started to get loose in the Colorado bullpen. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
You know, it's always nice to get that first one under your belt. When you start a four-game series on the road, it takes a little bit of the wind out of the sails of the guys in their home dugout and gives you confidence to come back and do it again tomorrow.
Here we are at Chase Field in Phoenix, Arizona, just about set for Friday Night Baseball on the show. Tonight, game two of this. Major League Baseball on the show starts into the box. Colton Welker.
The third baseman. Colton.
Bumgarner has his target. 0-1 on its way. High in the air out to center field. Long run for the center fielder. He gets there, and that's the second out. Striding in for the Rockies, Raimel Tapia. Lifetime numbers against Bumgarner. He carries a .421 batting average. He also has one home run. Vaughn finds some space out there for the catch to retire the. So next to hit is Dante Vaughn. He had a homer in the ballgame yesterday afternoon. First pitch of the AB on its way. Well, boys, we take a look at the Rockies' starting play here tonight. They were the spoilers here on opening day as they took game one of the season on the road.
Yeah, Matty, not easy to start.
Right here,
opening day on the road and grab a W in the opponent's ballpark. But that's what happened. And they come into game two with a chance to set the tone in this series.
That is cool. No left field.
Runners at the corners here with one gone in the inning. And that'll bring up the infielder Ketel Marte. Swing and a liner. Bonifacio is there, and that should be deep enough to score the run. And the run will score as the Diamondbacks take the early 1-0 lead. So the next to bat will be Christian Walker. His prior history versus this arm. He's batting 412. Two of those hits were for home runs.
Good running count right here. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, runner on first. He'll be off to the races on this pitch.
And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away. So now into the box is Eduardo Escobar. And now the Diamondbacks look to push more across in the opening frame. Skied down the left field line.
You're scoring.
He tracks it down, and that will one in the inning for Arizona. Now at the plate, here is Casey Golden, hitless in four tries in the ball game yesterday. Lifted into the air out towards center field. And it's a fly out to start the second, one away. Next up, Dante Vaughn.
The center fielder, Dante.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Vaughn is often heralded for his defensive capabilities patrolling the outfield. So much, in fact, it's not uncommon to hear the word elite when used in talking about his skill set. So I guess it goes without saying that his pitcher teammates always appreciate having him out there behind them.
Yeah, he just seems to be in the right place at the right time. I don't know if he could see the signs from out there, but it almost seems like he gets a jump before the pitch even reaches home plate. You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something clean.
Throw just in time, and oh, that was awfully close. Now to bat, Casey Golden. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. High fly ball out to straightaway center. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Three up, three down for Colorado. Now into the box, Dante Vaughn. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
Fastball called for strike two.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down the way, and that's exactly what that is. He swings it down.
As the ball gets down, let's see if they try to score. And this will not be close, and the run will score easily. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Ketel Marte, singled in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield.
On the bag, on the bag.
Good read there at second base to know he could make it to third on the flyout. Now he's only 90 feet away with one out.
Skied into straightaway right. Bonifacio's under it. Makes the catch. Here comes the runner from third. And he'll make it into score. It's a sack fly and an RBI, and it's now a 3-0 ball game.
Always productive to score runs when you can, and that sacrifice fly right there drives home the second run of the inning.
Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Popped up. Hampson is there, and the side is retired. Striding in is Dante Vaughn. He delivered an RBI single in his last trip. Here's the first pitch. Pitch misses low. The throw down is well behind the play. That's an easy stolen base. A throw behind the runner at second, and he has to dive, but he's back in easily. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Giving chase is Tapia. He gets there to put it away, but the runner tags and breaks for third.
LoCastro
is on his way home. He's in time, and he's cut down at the plate as they team up to gun it.
Your attention, please. Pinch-hitter for Colorado, number 7, Johnny.
Easy fly ball into shallow center field. Center fielder coming on. Long run, but he gets there to track this one down.
Yeah, that relief performance were tall. It would have had some wobbly wheels on it. He gave up a couple of runs, but he still gets the save, getting that shaky car across the finish line after all.
And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ball game. The D-backs jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. This evening, as we welcome you inside Chase Field here in Phoenix. Tonight, it's the third of this four-game weekend series. Lance Lynn, the right-hander out of Indiana, will be doing the pitching in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, Matty V, this ought to be a fun one to watch. This guy's been around the block for a while, but he's having a rock-solid season with a real good ERA. It'll be really interesting to see how he attacks his opposing lineup.
Hit in the air down the right field line. And foul. Here's the 0-1. Checked his swing there. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. Ball one. Runner at third here. Nobody out. Pass ball just inside. Well, boys, we take a look at the Rockies' starting play here tonight. It's official now. They will not go 162-0 as they were handed their first loss of the season last time out.
Yeah, Matty, they lost last game only by one run. Those are the tough ones. But I'm sure they've looked at the film, made a few adjustments, and let's see if they can give a better effort today.
It looked like the fastball got away from him there.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
Lifted in the air to shallow center field. Tapia's in pursuit, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass. Notch one in the score column as the runner from third crosses the plate.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Roy. You get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
Ground ball to second. This could be two. He's got it. There's one. On to first. Not in time as the umpire was right there to make the call. So stepping in is Sam Hilliard, trying here to plate the tying run from second. Lifted into center field. Vaughn is right there, one down. And he'll indeed move up 90 feet, putting runners at the plate. Up next for Arizona, Dante Vaughn. He singled first time up.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave them.
Ball one to start the at-bat. Here comes the 1-0.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
One there. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. Only one in the inning for Arizona. So now to the plate. Daniel Bell worked a walk his first time up. Now the 0-2 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center.
Relay, here we go, hitting you right here.
Vaughn is there, two gone. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning. So here's the cleanup hitter. Casey Golden struck out in his last trip to the plate. The set and the 1-2. Easy fly ball into shallow center field. Vaughn is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So ready to go for the last half of the inning. Digging in is the outfielder, Dante Vaughn.
Dante.
And a ball, 1-0.
Count 1-0.
There's not too many umpires in the game that are going to ring that first strike right there. That was borderline up, even though it was in the zone.
Now a half swing here as he wanted to pull it back, but he does so too late. It's strike one. Lays off a slider that time, 2-1. Now a right-hander has started to get loose in the Colorado bullpen. Lays off the changeup, and he's ahead in the count now, 3-1.
Well, that's ball three. The Diamondbacks right now would welcome a leadoff walk to start this inning.
Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third.
One time, right now. Here we go.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And that misses ball four now. It's a leadoff walk to get the home half of the fifth underway.
And this is exactly what you want to do when you're trying to put a start away. Make him work his tail off, throw a lot of pitches, and get on base any way that you can. A big inning at this point of the game, and he's probably gone.
Well, this is hauled in by the second baseman. One out, runner at first, and into hit next, it'll be Austin Slater. Here's the 1-1. Runners on the move for second. Pitch is a called strike. The throw is not close as he's in there with a stolen base. So now here is Austin Slater. A couple of walks for him thus far. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Got him.
Wow, that's awfully impressive right there. The pitch before was really close. Called the ball. What does he do? He comes back with a better pitch and gets the punch out.
Takes this the other way to right. That's in there. Base hit. Vaughn ignores his coach. He's chugging for home. And they'll tag him out at the plate. And that will. Top half of the sixth about to get started. And set to go is the third baseman, Tristan Casas. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Center fielder on the run. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. High leverage at bat here, and standing in, it'll be Dante Vaughn, as he'll do his best to bring home the go-ahead run from the third, 90 feet away. Looking to minimize the damage here. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. And this pitch is popped straight up, right around the home plate area. Bell will put this one away, and the side is retired. Ready to begin the eighth, and next to hit is the catcher, Donnie Bell. Hit in the air to center field. Vaughn has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first down. The batter will be Sam Hilliard. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Now a ball lined toward the gap in left center. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. He hit the corner and tries for third. And he's in there at third with a one-out triple.
And that's his first triple of the season. The way he exploded out of the box, you knew he was determined to get the third, and he made it happen.
High in the air out to center field. Catch is made. Runner tagging from third. And a big RBI there as the run scores to make this a two-run game now.
Every team is looking.
So a big at-bat coming up, and it'll be Dante Vaughn. And a big at-bat here as he'd be the go-ahead run. And he lays off there, 1-0.
This is where you got to take stock in the situation. Adjust your batting gloves and realize you need a gapper to score this guy from first. If nothing less, pass the baton to the guy behind you and keep the line moving.
Fuentes is under it, and that's the third out. to start the ninth in this one. And here's Josh Fuentes to the batter's box. Sent out to straightaway center field. And the leadoff man retired here to kick off the ninth. Stepping up is Raimel Tapia. Singled home a run in his last time up. High in the air out to center field. Long run for the center fielder. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning.
And a nice job here to come in and slam the door. That's his first save of the season. That certainly won't be his last.
And tonight's one-run game comes to an end 6-5 for final.
They left 11 men on base.
Afternoon baseball at Chase Field. Dallas Keuchel is on the mound for the Diamondbacks. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
We're looking at one of the top pitchers in the league right now. ERA just above 3 last year, which is saying something. This guy commands the strike zone. He's not afraid to throw strike 1, controls the running game. A real solid pitcher. And if he pitches like he did last year,
his ball is down, and that could bring in a run. The throw is wild, and he gets away. Now he's safe at third as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play.
Well, there's one way to get our first run of the game across. Good hustle there on an RBI triple, and they're in good shape to possibly make it 2-0 with another base hit here.
Next to stand in is Ketel Marte. And now the Diamondbacks look to push more across in the opening frame. Golden has it, and I'd be surprised if they send the runner. And even with two away now, that ball just didn't get out there deep enough, so they'll hold him at third base. Now it'll be Christian Walker. He's picked up 3 hits in the series and driven in 4 along the way. Ground ball right side. Throw to first in time, and the big inning. And that'll bring in Garrett Hampson. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first base line. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Dante Vaughn. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball 1.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but it's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
Diamondback center fielder with a friendly 2-0 count. Two balls and a strike.
We got 2 balls.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
This is in the air to left field. Golden is there, and he makes the catch for the out. Digging in will be Dante Vaughn. Flew out last time up. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. And he fouls this one off.
Well, just like your fielders pick you up sometimes right here, he's got a chance to pick his guy up after that error would have ended the inning. It's a team game.
I got a ball, one strike.
And he takes this one high, 1-1.
Man, this guy's had their number all game long. Up, down, in and out. He's pitching very well.
Swing, and he pops him up.
Come on,
Dick, get him out. Hampson is there for it. He hauls it in, and the potential go-ahead run will not come around. So here now is the pitcher, John Gray. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Vaughn is there, and he'll bring this one in. And that'll bring up Jorge Bonifacio. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Hits it high and deep out to center field. And that one is gone on a 2-strike count with 2 away in the inning. Leading off the inning, it'll be Dante Vaughn, and they could use a spark from him here.
I'm sure at the plate right there, he's thinking stay up the middle, hard line drives to either gap. He did it one better, giving his team the lead right there with a huge three-run bomb.
And low, it's a ball and a strike. That's in there on the outer half. One
ball,
and two now.
Two strikes.
I mean, he's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
Here comes the 1-2. Oh, and it's not often you see a guy like that flail so badly up there, but that was a great pitch.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Thank you for Colorado. Number 8, Josh Hamilton.
Sent in the air out to straightaway center. And the pinch hitter is retired here, one away. Next to hit, Dante Vaughn. He went down on strikes in his last at bat. First pitch on its way. Oof, looks like he's chasing butterflies with that swing. It's 0-1.
You know what that ugly swing tells me right there? This guy's got his good slider working. That thing's got depth and bite.
And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Bases are empty, one man out. And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2.
Well, there's the classic 0-2 wasted fastball. Not even close to the zone. We'll see what he throws on the next pitch.
The 1-2. Misses. Ball
two.
Two
strikes.
Oh, a fastball swung on and missed. And for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
I really liked it. He gave up nibbling out of the zone trying to get him to chase. That wasn't working, so he just reached back and fired a good old country hardball fastball right by him. No better feeling in the world when you're a pitcher than throwing a fastball right by a guy.
One run finish today, 5-4 the final score. The Diamondbacks came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Alex Young claims the win out of the pen, his first. So that'll do it for us.